Hello, everybody. Today I want to talk a little bit about Goa, India, and visiting Goa, India. As I did this research, it was an extreme surprise to find out everything that you're about to hear about Goa. You'll be very surprised and hopefully very interested about traveling to this place on the west coast of India, just south of Mumbai. It's actually, according to most of the studies, it's one of the wealthiest places in all of India, and actually only has a GDP per capita of about 6,000 or 7,000 per person. So there are two major airports in Goa. One is basically South Goa, and the other one is North Goa, and they have airport initials GOI or GOX. And it actually can be pretty confusing, but most likely you'll be probably flying to the South airport, but they have about the same number of flights. Usually you'll fly into Mumbai or New Delhi and then fly to Goa from there. So it's not a whole lot of direct international flights, but those are the main ones. So I was really surprised. India actually has a pretty strict visa policy. They have everything has to be done electronically, e-visa, and you can basically get 30 to 180 days on electronic visa. And you'll notice here, just about everywhere except for Japan and South Korea, and even that, I'm not even sure. I would doubt. You know, on this map, you can see basically everywhere requires electronic visa for entry. So I wanted to talk a little bit about this map. You'll notice Goa is on the west coast of India. It's kind of where right where it starts to get pretty rainy along the west coast. At certain parts of the year, particularly in the summertime, it gets pretty rainy in the spring here as well. And then the rain kind of shifts on the wintertime to the other coast. A lot of people here think of this as one of the main maps because it's basically the start of the rest of Southeast Asia. You have Thailand in the background here, Myanmar, and some other places, Sri Lanka. The other thing I would mention is that actually Goa is a lot like Sri Lanka. I've already done a study of Sri Lanka, and some of the same problems that you experience in Sri Lanka, you may not experience in Goa. Actually, you may have more problems in Goa than in Sri Lanka traveling. But Colombo is still pretty far from some of the beaches there. Goa is actually quite far. It can take you a couple hours just to get to your destination. But this map I really like too because it shows you basically how far Goa is from most of the other major attractions like Bali, Phuket, Da Nang, and the Philippines, and basically all of Indonesia in here. So basically it is quite far. Sri Lanka is right over here as well. And so if you're thinking of planning a trip, a lot of Indians actually look at the map like this. They put India in the center. And actually that means that Doha Qatar is actually quite a frequent flight out of from Goa. Actually it's from Mumbai, so basically you fly up to from Mumbai down to Goa and then back. So most of the flights will be through Mumbai probably. And then actually the Middle East is quite a popular tourist place, even for Pakistanis, Sri Lankans, and a lot of people actually do travel this way, believe it or not. There's actually a lot of money being made in the Middle East, so a lot of people actually travel that way rather than traveling into Southeast Asia. So it's kind of a very different situation. I think without the Middle East here, situation in all of India, in all Pakistan, Afghanistan would be very different because the wealth concentrated in UAE, Saudi Arabia, Kuwait, and then Dubai here, and Oman. It's just totally different. So basically a lot of people try to just strike it rich there and travel over there. But Goa actually is that destination for Indians. There's the wealth is actually along the beach here in Mumbai. So you'll see that a lot of the wealth in India is actually out of New Delhi and Mumbai, and then actually Goa. And actually Goa is some people consider wealthier than many other parts of India. Let's look really quickly at those two airports. You might get a little bit confused about Goa. So there's basically two major beaches. There's this beachfront here. This is South Goa. So basically the actual map is going to be like this. So there's basically north to south, you'll see as you zoom out here, this is India, right? And Goa is basically right over there. So, and then Sri Lanka's down in here. So it's basically kind of, this is the state of Goa right here. It's actually quite wealthy, and you can see that there's definitely a rainy season that hits right along here. And that's actually one of the rainiest parts of India, I would say. Bangladesh gets a lot of that rain as well, but you can see here that this airport is a little bit strange because it's actually quite far from the beach. You can see it's a little bit more than, I would say 20 miles, right? So, and this is not 20 miles like in the United States or 20 miles in European miles. These are really rough roads. I've looked at the roads here. It's nothing like you might expect. So basically, this is North Goa. A lot of the people prefer the beaches on North Goa. The capital region is called Panaji, and I actually have a friend there. I was really surprised. I had no idea what this Panaji was all about, and actually it's a very important place. If you're going to Goa, you're gonna have to know about what Panaji is. It's basically the administrative center of Goa. So a lot of the maybe visa things and other stuff will be handled there. So you can see that this is really the wrong airport to be looking at. This is probably the main airport that most people travel into. A lot of people prefer this because it's closer to Panaji. You can see only, the problem is you have to go around this bridge and it actually becomes 10 or even 20 miles. And these roads are not anything like you would expect at all. So there are mainly two lane roads. So you have one lane roads on one lane on either side. Lots of potholes and just not anything like you'd expect. So I was really surprised just to see at some of these details. And I'll show you some of these bridges and details later. But basically the problem is you'll fly into this airport. There's not a whole lot of people on this beach for some reason. It's a huge beach. But compared to this beach, most of the tourist attractions are actually on this beach here. So you're actually trying to get from this airport in this airport over here. It's actually considered maybe even further, and because really this part of the journey is quite difficult, no matter what you do. So really what happens is that from the airport you kind of swing around here and then you follow some of these side roads and you head along the beachfront this way. So you end up going around Panaji to get there. So let's get into some other details for a second that aren't so detailed. So what are we talking about getting there? Basically, what you'll find is you'll have to fly through Mumbai, and then a lot of Indians will also fly through New Delhi to get to Goa. So, but the flights are not too bad. You'll see Singapore is about $103 to Goa, so that's a very good flight just to sense. I think, let's see, Phuket, I'm not sure what the Phuket prices are, so it's around $300. So that's a one-way ticket. So it is pretty pricey. It is cheaper from Sri Lanka in general. And that's just because it's also closer. But really, it's kind of strange because these airports, I don't know, there's just something about the airports in Goa that have always been difficult. I think they tried to build a second airport there recently on the north side. And still that is causing problems because it's so hard to get to the beach from the airport. They really need to build a road from the airport to the beach that will really help out, actually. So, and that could be very expensive as well. So, it may be just cheaper for them to build the airport than it was to build the road to the beach. So, one of the surprising things is this is GOI. So, this is the main airport on the south side. And you'll see most of those flights, about 97 flights, and then Mumbai actually. So actually, you'll probably fly through Mumbai, but that's that flight there. So, and again, you will need the electronic visa. And then here is the other Mumbai list. So I was really surprised. Actually, India doesn't really have a lot of international flights out of Mumbai. You know, you'll see Delhi being a top hit here. And that's really because it's so far west on the map. If you look at India here on this map, basically a lot of the flights will be internal here. It's just it's kind of a big deal to leave India and head into Southeast Asia from some of these maps here. And when I looked at my route, doing some traveling in Asia, you know, basically Sri Lanka was a top priority. Down here in Bali was a major priority. Phuket, Da Nang, and then trying to figure out what to do about the Philippines, just because the situation there in Manila is actually quite complicated as well. Like when you fly into the airport there, there's no beaches in Manila, and you may actually have to take a flight somewhere else just to get to a beach. So it is quite complicated getting around Manila, as well as even in Goa. So, but I was just very surprised. So you're going to see some of the pictures of the street view here in a moment. But basically, Goa is very different than the rest of India, and it still has a lot of the characteristics that you'll see of most of the other cities in India. So let's look at international flights. So basically to New York, you would spend around $600 for that one-way flight. So that could be quite expensive. Europe and Paris is around $300 or $400 to Europe. And then you see these other flights like to Hong Kong, $300. And Singapore still being a very cheap alternative. So basically, you want to keep Singapore on your map as you're thinking about this. And then Bali, $300 or even $400 for that flight. So one of the main problems is that the cost could take, now this is 1 week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks, that's like 5 weeks just to get the price down. So you may have to stay in Goa for quite a long time just to get the price down low there. And this is from Goa to Bali, so that's $380 one-way trip. Now the other alternative is heading into Bangkok. Now Bangkok has pretty stable prices pretty much all the time. Problem is you'd have to go from Bangkok somewhere else, and that may mean a week or so in Thailand. So in general, that flight out to Bali, although it is a little more expensive, it is actually just a lot cheaper to fly to Thailand. Here's Phuket, it's $256. For that flight, the one-way trip from Goa to Phuket. And the good news is that that flight is pretty much pretty stable flight price. So it's just a good price almost the following day, which is great. Now, I was a little bit surprised reading the State Department's page on safety. Basically, India is considered a level two. There are many places. It's probably about like Mexico, maybe even a little bit more dangerous than Mexico. It kind of shows up here as not, it's hard to say. So you have to really look through the details here to see what parts of India are not really safe. And basically they consider the East Coast not as safe as the West Coast in general, and the central part of India as most dangerous. So that's kind of the rural areas are considered more dangerous, as well as the border regions, particularly between Kashmir, Pakistan, and the eastern states. So basically, let me show you what that means. So basically this area over here, Bangladesh, and also up here near Pakistan, they consider it not so great. And then some of this internal region here is not considered that safe. So I would also argue that many of the locations along the Central Valley, including New Delhi, are not super great as well. It basically means Goa is perhaps one of the safer alternatives, and you'll really see that Goa is not what you think at all. So one of the funny things about Western India is there is a lot of Christians. Actually, 25% of Goans are Christians, so it's kind of like a really kind of a click. Hinduism is very big. Islam is pretty big in Goa as well. So it is kind of has some foreign influences. And actually, they don't even speak a lot of Hindi in Goa as well, which is kind of funny. They speak a different language there as well. Now here you can see the average current GDP per capita. And I don't know how accurate this is, but this is very low, as you can see. So one of the problems all throughout India is basically people are making almost nothing, $2,000 per year. So that's really low budget. And for that matter, they don't even have the hotel services or other things in many of the rural areas. So you just want to be really cautious about that. And actually, it's pretty high prices for some of the hotels in Goa. You'll be surprised. One of the best things about Goa is the weather. It's 78 degrees. You can see 80 degrees. So it's pretty much pretty stable around 80 degrees, 81 degrees year round, which is really nice. Here's a map. I'm not sure if I showed this map earlier, but you can basically see North Goa here, and then South Goa, and then this is the whole state of Goa, giving you some ideas. But you'll probably just want to stay near this beach here, or this beach up in here. So, but basically this is the weather, temperatures, and climate for Goa. Now what I did is I came up with like a little tourist kind of trip to see what you might want to see if you actually were to visit Goa, and try to get some ideas for what this all is. And it's actually really quite surprising. I didn't put too much on the beach down south here, but I did show some photos later on, so you can see what that looks like. So one of the things you're going to be extremely surprised about, the population is basically mostly in North India, as you can see, as well as some of the airports. The red airport is Goa right here. So this is a major airport. They don't have a whole lot of major airports in India, believe it or not. For this number of people, there's actually not a whole lot of airports. So, but the population is actually quite heavy in Goa, as you'll see on some of the street views. So here's some of the hotels. Now, I was just really surprised at the prices. So basically, I don't know if these prices are negotiable or how negotiable they are. There are some hotels on the $15 range here. You can see that one right there, and then this hotel here. So it's basically, I would say $40 a night, $50 a night you should pretty much expect from Goa here. So it actually could be, it could add up quite quickly, paying for those fees. And here you can see the airport on the south side. So there are a number of hotels on the south side beaches here. So basically, let me just zoom out so you can see where we are on this whole thing. So basically, this is the tip of India again, right? And then we're looking at hotels right along here, basically in this Goa region. So basically, it may actually be easier to get to the south side beaches, but one of the reasons a lot of people like the north side beaches because there's kind of some tourist attractions, some cliffs and some cool things that don't quite show up along the flat beach here. And it's actually even hard to get to. Remember, this is 2 miles, so it's actually quite difficult to get around. So this is pretty much a 4 mile long beach here. That is considered the main part of Goa, and it is just difficult to get around. So I don't know how the taxi service works and all that other stuff, but it's going to be a little bit difficult to get around, to say the least. Once you see the roads, you'll be super surprised. There's a lot of film industry all throughout India. Some of that is in Goa, and you might want to check that out just to see. Now I wanted to show you the visa application process. This is the website, the official website. One thing I'd recommend is looking at the sample form. They have that, you can select that, and this is the sample form website link here, and see exactly how to fill it out. There is quite extensive. There's just many, many pages here, and that's just to get the visa for India. So I think part of that is because of the safety concerns. They're just trying to make you very aware that there's a lot of, it's a serious trip going to India. So next, we're going to look at, there's basically no public transportation option to get from the beach by bus to this Bega beach. That's the main beach that I would say that you should be concerned about if you're thinking about going to Goa. So, and then up here is this like little lookout area, which is very beautiful. There's another lookout area right over here. So it's kind of hilly off on that side. So, and then as you leave the Goa International Airport, you'll see it's just gonna be really complicated. So there's just a whole lot of really complicated ways to get around here. If you get from the airport, you should definitely, it's just not gonna be a straight route at all. So And you can see that definitely shows up here. So if you're interested in some of the, part of the problem is that some of the church areas and Portuguese areas are back in here on this tour that I wanted to do for everybody. And then once you get over the beach, you have to turn here, and then you go down over here on this road here, and it's just many, many miles of complicated roads. So, and then even on this road, as you'll see, it's very slow going. So pretty much it's all just one lane road heading out there. So here is that church area. So if you wanted to see basically what that looks like, basically it's a Portuguese colony, and they built this kind of off to the side. There's not actually a whole lot of people in this image here, as you can see, but it's interesting to see. So next, you're gonna see some of these ferries and ways to get around, and it's just not gonna be what you think at all. So basically, you know, the ticket negotiation prices, all that can be complicated. Remember, there is a language barrier sometimes. A lot of people do speak English in India, but it can still be pretty complicated. And if you look closely at this picture, you'll even see some cows just roaming the streets. So there's basically, it's quite different than you might expect. So this is about what the street would look like as you're heading to Goa. You can see taking some screenshots here to show what this looks like for everybody to see. And as you look around, there's going to be some restaurants and different kinds of places. And definitely here on the right, you can see airport, and shows directions to the airport. So this is kind of the pathway that you might take on the way to and from the airport. Again, here's the picture of the beach. So when you arrive at the beach, Bega Beach, it's probably gonna look something like this. There's quite a lot of people already in India, and you'll see quite a lot of people on the beach. And this is even, I think, near sunset time. You can see the sun kind of setting. And actually, I was really surprised. All throughout India, there's gonna be quite a lot of pollution, even in, believe it or not, right along the ocean front. So it might really surprise you. Again, if you look carefully, you're almost gonna have to like, where's Waldo for cows in some of these pictures, but you'll see a cow just right there on the beach. Here's some more pictures. You'll see like one white tourist here, maybe another couple tourists there, but basically definitely not maybe what you might expect from a normal beach town. So some of these lookout areas, you'll see you can climb these hills, and it is quite steep, as you can see here. This is one of the forts, but on this fort you'll get a pretty good view. And the view will hopefully look something like this. Here's another perspective near the rocks, so you can kind of see what that might look like. The really sad part about all this, these great views, is that you're basically not even near the hotels or anything. There's basically, it is actually kind of a mile or so just to get to this point. Here's kind of another sunset view along the cliff that you can see here. And then heading back down to the beach, you can see basically that cliff area was off over there. And you can see basically what the beach might look like at sunset. So let me just review this tour here, what we just did. We basically had this crazy road that we have to get over to the beach on, and then we still have this long way here, and then the hotels are somewhere in here. And again, it's still pretty pricey for the hotels compared to Thailand or even Indonesia. So I was pretty surprised at that. And then this Chupra Fort, we were kind of looking at some of those beaches right along here. So there's kind of these lookout points. And as you can see, there's a couple hotels in here, but most hotels are back in here. And this is actually quite a number of, you know, you can't just go straight up the hill on some of these places. You have to kind of go all the way around here, maybe get a taxi or rent a scooter or something. So that can be all very complicated and even dangerous on the scooter getting around. So there are some other beaches that look pretty cool. And then there's this little inlet that we looked at. But basically some of those hill areas were off over here. So again, you'd be flying in from here, GOA International, which is, again, this is 2 miles here, this is another 2 miles here, another 2 miles here, another 2 miles here, another 2 miles there. So it could be quite difficult getting around in general. Now, back in the town of Panaji, you'll see these like walkways along the waterfront here. And it's very busy. I called my friend in India and talked with him about it, and it is just like really noisy nonstop. But just wanted to kind of give you a view of what this riverfront walk looks like. And then here you can see people waiting for a ferry, kind of a really strange ferry entrance. I don't know how they get the ferry over here. Looks like low tide or something during this time. Now, the south side beaches are very different. You can see not a whole lot of people at all on the south side beach. Maybe some people down here, but really different overall. Now, I just wanted to show you these have these turnarounds. This is also in down near downtown Panaji. So they're trying to make some beach areas near here. So that way you can be in Panaji and just go to the beach. But they're still kind of working on it as of this video. Now, I would say it's super important to really carefully look at some of these street views just so you can see precisely what's going on. This is mostly in Panaji, downtown area, but I also did a lot of Goa shots too, right along the beach, like a couple blocks from the beach. But you can see there's a lot of people sitting around on the side here, a lot of scooters, just a ton of scooters going around. But it can be very helpful to give you a preview of what it's gonna be like. So I'm gonna really quickly go through these last few photos. I have in the upper left-hand corner, you can see the intersection. But I just wanted to give you some perspectives of what this looks like. A lot of the buildings actually are pretty old, and it looks quite different than you might expect. Now here's back at the Bega Beach area, so you can kind of see we're getting close to some of these turnarounds. As you're gonna probably even see this exact street as you get towards the beach. So there's kind of like a weird statue here, but these are actually some of the bars and areas are covered up pretty differently. They're kind of even kind of falling apart a little bit. A police officer here as well. So I don't know if you can tell, but this is more of the beachfront area. You can see maybe even a tourist here on the side, but maybe not quite what you might expect out of Goa. So here's kind of a weird little park intersection in Panaji. I just wanted to show this because a lot of people are very aware of this particular park that live in here. You can see a tourist kind of like packed to the brim in this small car with luggage, and just a lot of little street scenes that you definitely should be aware of. But this park here definitely is something that a lot of people are familiar with and in Panaji. So it's just very, very busy all in Panaji. So basically a lot of people just head straight to the beach, and that's why a lot of tourists don't stay here, just because it might be a little bit cheaper, but there's basically no beach like there is north of here or south of here. So taking me back to the airport, again, this is not like a major airport in the United States. We're in Europe. It's very different. As you can see, there's just a ton of people outside, and you can see it says like welcome to the Goa International Airport, and it's just really different. There's even a lot of homeless people actually in the area, so you kind of got to be careful. I would say get into a cab and definitely try to get to the beach as soon as you can, but it's very different than you might expect. Now, as you're heading over to the beach, you may see you'll have to cross a couple bridges. It's probably gonna look something like this. And as you can see, it is tight. Like, so this is like one car is going this way, and they also drive on the opposite side of the road, not on the right side, they drive on the left side. So it's pretty different. It's really tight traffic all the way, so you can expect many hours just to get to the beach. Here's another bridge crossing. This is on the other side of Panaji, different style of bridge entirely. You can see some of the ferries over here as well. So there's basically like two or even three bridges. This is the third bridge that you'd have to cross, and you can see it's almost like a dirt road heading out to the beach. And this is like one of their major beaches in all of India. So it's definitely, there's some work that needs to be done here on the road system, particularly in Goa. So last, I wanted to show you some more of the local side of Goa. These are some of the major markets, the food markets that they have here. So there's basically one major market on the south side. There's the Panaji, essentially the Panaji market. There's one on the beach here, and there's one kind of a little bit outside the beach. And I think the reason this market here kind of started the other airport. So basically, because of some of these marketplaces, they decided to build the airport. So it's kind of a strange way to think about it. But so I just wanted to show you two pictures. Hopefully you'll get kind of a view of how busy these streets are. So you basically cannot drive down these streets in a normal car. I'd have to do that all early in the morning to fill up the place, but basically give you an idea of what some of these marketplaces looks like. And then one last view here of this other market. You can see very densely populated, lots of little shops along the street here, kind of like a little intersection with a roundabout here, but basically give you some idea of what these shops look like. So that's my tour of Goa, India. I hope you really enjoyed it. It's certainly not what I expected at all. And you can see basically the poverty is really felt in India, you know, like the $6,000, $7,000 per year. That actually may actually be accurate. Those numbers, as hard as they are to believe, but basically Goa, India, located right here on the west coast, is an interesting beach town to check out. But I would definitely say you want to get your transportation really squared away properly, so you can get around on in Goa. And basically that's true in Bali, as well as in, even more so in Phuket, and Da Nang, India, or excuse me, Da Nang, Vietnam, pretty much put you around the beach here. I gotta get going here, but I really hope you enjoyed this study. Please let me know what other kind of details you'd like to know about Goa. I'd be glad to talk with you and work with you on them. Thank you so much.